What does this have to do with powering a factory? Hi, I'm Ranger Bernard from Lowell National Historical Park, and today I'm going to show you how to make a model of a flyball governor, a device that controls the speed of a water wheel, a turbine, or a steam engine. So, when this governor is spinning, it looks a lot like this. Let's learn more about what the governor does, how it works, and how you can create one too. Textile factories, places where people make cloth on big machines, need a lot of power. And if the turbines or engines that provided the factories with power ran too fast, they could cause a lot of damage when they broke. That's where the governor comes in. Here at Lowell National Historical Park, there is a Lombard governor built in 1898. This device uses leather belts for power, creating oil pressure to move a piston controlling a gate on a turbine. This determines how much water can go into the turbine, keeping it at the same speed. At the top, the flyball feels how fast it's spinning using several metal balls and a big spring. If you spin in a circle or swing a weight on a string, your arms or the weight will lift or drop depending on how fast you're spinning. The faster we spin, the higher the ball or the weight goes. This pulls apart the spring, moving a valve, making the piston move in or out, allowing more or less water into the turbine. So if the fly ball drops too low, that also speeds up the machinery. But how did the engineers who designed and built it know it would work? Engineers, architects, scientists, artists, and many other people often make models, smaller versions of their idea. Models can help people see if their idea is a good one, test ways of making it better, and show others how it works. So, let's make our model. For this activity, you're going to need the following materials: a roll of sticky tape, a pencil. If it's worn down with a little bit of an eraser left, but not much, that's actually even better. A push pin, two toothpicks, a small bathroom or paper cup, 4 pennies, a larger paper clip, a rubber band, and a pair of scissors. The cup is going to be to make our stand, so we can set it aside for now. Let's start by making the arms of our governor. So, I'm going to take the rubber band and make a cut. Just like that. I want to measure where the middle is by holding it over my pencil and pulling lightly on the ends. Looks like it's right about there. Now, I'm going to take my pin and put it through the rubber band into the eraser. Like that. To make these a little stronger, I'm going to stretch them out slightly and tape a toothpick to each end of the rubber band. Want to use a little bit of tape to help to keep my pin in place. So just 2 small pieces. Notice that the tape I've used doesn't tape the rubber band or the toothpicks stiff. They can still move around. The valve that controls the speed of the turbine has to go up and down. If I put this on my pencil now, it's gonna stick. So I wanna lightly bend it open, but I also don't want it to slide from side to side. So once I figure out where the middle is, taking part of the inside of the paperclip, I'm going to bend it as a stop. See the bend? Now, I'm going to thread my arms through each side of the paperclip. So far, so good. We need to add our weights. Taking a piece of tape, simply tape one penny to the little end of rubber band that's sticking out, and tape a second penny over the front, like you're making a little sandwich. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Now, when I spin this back and forth really quickly by twisting it in my hands, the arms should lift up and it should pull the paper clip higher, just like the real governor. See? If you want to show off or set your governor model aside, we'll go back to the cup. And to make sure that you're not taking the tip of your pencil and making marks all over the table, we'll take a little cross of tape. Just like that. That's also going to help to make sure the model doesn't wobble when it falls over. Then just poke a hole in the top of the cup and push down. And there we have it. This is our model of the governor. Of course, you don't have to stop where we have today. You can change or improve your models. So look around, see what you can come up with. We'd love to see what you do. And if you share your creations on social media, be sure to tag the park here on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. And of course, you can also tag the Songus Industrial History Center on Facebook or Twitter here. Naturally, you can always visit us here at Lowell National Historical Park to explore more of today's topic. I'm Ranger Bernard, saying, keep on creating.